Hey guys, welcome back. I know it's been a little while since my last video, and I haven't been playing very much lately. And the reason for that is I'm really not feeling very well. It all started when I was finishing up my day as a virgin neet, and on my way home from GameStop, a delivery truck was about to hit a child crossing a road. I pushed the kid out of the way, but the truck hit me, and the next thing I knew, I was reborn into another world that operated like an RPG video game as a level maxed adventurer boy in a starter town. After I joined the local guild, I quested to defeat the demon lord. Long story short, many over-sexualized cat women joined my harem, and whenever they made advances on me, I'd get flustered for some reason and ran away. But I'm feeling much better now, so let's talk about form.
Did I hear you say you wanted to be like me? Then watch closely.
What? You want me to do that? Can I really do something like that?
Have you ever noticed that some stamina players, when you look at their feet when they play, sometimes they look a little different? The way that you move and control your feet when you play stamina, which, is the result of this muscle memory that you build up from lots of practice, we call that form. So most new players, they step very wide. Most people who play stamina, they play DDR before or pump it up or something like that. Sometimes they'll play on their toes. They're making big movements where they're moving their feet. As players get more experienced, I mean, really particularly with stamina, their form usually becomes more minimal to allow them to save energy. If you save your energy, you can play longer songs, you can play faster songs, you can avoid getting tired and getting injured. As your form gets more minimal, it tends to go one of two directions. Those directions are you put your heels out or you put your toes out. Your form can explode, or you might not be able to hold your form. This is something that you'll experience when you get tired or when you try to push your speed. Sometimes your feet just can't keep up with what you want to do. And when this happens, your movements get more sloppy and they get more wide. And that's what we mean when we say you can't hold your form. Just a reminder for people who don't actually play in the groove or stamina, it's not just about hitting arrows, it's also about lifting your feet. And that's a big part of your form as well. You might see somebody playing high-level stamina and say, "Well, I can slide around and do that. I can move just as fast with my feet." And you may, but if you don't lift your feet up, then you'll either get held misses or you'll get decents and way offs. Being a little conscious of the form that you have or the form that you want to have is kind of interesting because some patterns and charts are a little bit easier or harder depending on the form that you have. I'm really not the best person to ask about charts and patterns and stuff, so I won't focus too much on that. So forms do vary between players, and they do usually change over time. The form that you have now probably won't be the one that you have a year or two from now. That's the case for me. Your form might even change throughout your set. As you start off and you're warming up and you're playing slower songs, you might play with one form, and as you speed up or play longer songs, you might change forms a little bit. This might all just be happening subconsciously and you're not even really aware of it. It's just part of your muscle memory. Now, I really can't prove this at all, so just take this as big grain of salt. I'm not an expert in sports injuries or anything. I think that keeping a solid form might have something to do with preventing repetitive stress injuries that you might get from playing stamina and doing our hobby. For anyone who doesn't know, I mean, we're playing songs with thousands of steps. We're playing songs that might last an hour. They might last 2 hours, 3 hours, or in that one case, 7 hours. If you're doing something that's hurting yourself a little bit, that might be okay for a couple hundred times, but you do it 10,000 times or 50,000 times or over the course of your set, that can really add up. So when I thought about making a video about form, I immediately thought about this program called Arrow Vortex. It is a step charting program, and it has a cool feature called the dancing bot. So if you turn on this dancing bot widget, it's a little window, and as you play your chart in our vortex, it'll actually show you the footsteps. The problem is, the form that they use in our vortex is crazy. And for normal dancing is fine, but if you're playing a stamina song and your form looks like this, I really think that could be impossible. I mean, I don't know how people could play high level stamina like that. So what I've done is I tried to hand animate what the dancing bot might look like with some of these stamina forms. This is my first time like animating anything. All of the animations look pretty steppy. Steppy versus slidey. You know, it's kind of related to like socks and shoes. You slide more on with socks and you're stepping more on shoes, but you can do one on the other. There's also a component of that to the patterns and the step charting. You can have a steppy pattern versus a slidey pattern. I'm sure somebody else can make a great video unpacking that, but it ain't me. So what I did is I animated this little chart, and thank you, Matt, by the way, for helping me write this little one measure chart. We're going to look at this chart and how you would play it with all these different styles of form. Now, I will preface this in saying that people don't tend to match these exactly. There's like a continuum a player might find themselves in, like I'm a little bit closer to this one, or I'm this mixed with that. So keep in mind when looking at these animations that the you're just seeing the feet move. Where you see the ankles, there is a leg attached to it. So there's a lot of effort in moving that leg wherever you see the ankles move, versus a movement where you just pivot around your ankles might be a little bit easier. If you just took a person off the street and you were like, okay, this is a person playing DDR, what is the most minimal movement you would make to hit all of these four panels? I think they would tell you, they would describe straight form. Straight form uses the very little or no ankle rotation and uses your legs essentially to hit all of the arrows. Left and right are hit with the sides of your whole foot, and up is hit with the toes, and the bottom is hit with the heel. I don't actually know many players who play like this. Bran is the closest one that comes to mind, although, you know, technically he might be one of these other categories or mix the two. When you look at Bran play, maybe even more so a couple years ago, you'll see that his feet are very straight, and he's making deliberate movements to kind of like pull his feet into the center and then go up or down. This is the form that I've always desired to have, probably because I, you know, was watching Bran for a long time before I played stamina. As time went on, I ended up going to one of these other forms, but that's always what I wanted to be. In this form, it's hard not to touch the side arrows when you go for up and down, and to prevent that, you have to kind of like pull your feet into the middle a little bit. I suspect that this form might be a little bit better for less sensitive arrows, especially on the left and the right. Nato made a good comment. He says that straight form is unique, in my opinion, because it only requires foot translation rather than translation plus rotation. And I thought that was a good way to put it. Archai says, there's too much foot contact when you keep your foot straight. One of the ways that people cope with repeated arrows at high BPMs is to plant some part of their foot as a base and then use that as a fulcrum. If the length of your foot is on the arrow, that means that the entire foot has to be raised to avoid holding the arrow down. The next one is heels out. Unfortunately, I am a heels out degenerate, but not by choice. Heels out makes you look like a bashful anime schoolgirl.
No, just me, senpai!
The heels reach out wide to hit the left and right arrows. A turn of the ankle and a bit of leg movement can reach that down arrow. So it uses heels for arrows left, right, and down, and then toes for up. And some players target the center of the up arrow, making kind of like a V. Other players, kind of like me, will hit the edges of the up arrow. But when players hit down and left and right, they need to turn their ankles and move their heel a little bit. Prawn Skunk says, non-optimal. Swiveling heel, but pivoting on the ball of your foot. Struggles on modern high-level bass charts. A lot of mocking reactions, like, I don't know how you do it, man.
It literally doesn't make sense. Your heels are going like 90 degrees.
Prawn Skunk said, Ian.
It's such a weird concept to me, because that does not look comfy in the slightest.
Yeah, Prawn Skunk seems like the most dramatic heels out player that I know who's playing right now. Prawn Skunk also said, and I agree with him, that I think the optimal modding for heels out is to have lower left and right panels a little bit than the other forms. Based form is toes out. Okay, so the last one was heels out. This one is toes out. I don't know the story about why it's called base form, but it's also called wiper, like a windshield wiper on a car. So with base form, the toes can reach the up and the sides with a twist of an ankle. And then to hit down, you hit the down arrow with your heel. So it's kind of like the reverse of heels out, right? Toes out versus heels out. But it's not really. The reason why is because your heel is located in the right place for base form. You can hit three of the arrows on the top without moving your legs at all. It's just pivoting your ankle. But in heels out, to hit every arrow, you have to move your legs. That is the big difference between heels out and toes out. So it really appears that toes out or base form, whatever you want to call it, is the most efficient. You can kind of think of that like parallel parking. Like parallel parking is always easier to go from behind because of where the wheels that turn are. But if you tried to parallel parking front ways, it doesn't work right. Something interesting that this form shows us is why the shape of an arcade panel matters. If you ever look at like an older DDR or Pump It Up panel, they're actually octagonal. They're not square. And that's because there's brackets that sit and hold the panel down on these edges that are kind of cut off. If you look at the way the panels are laid out, in between two panels, there's kind of like a diamond in between of dead space. That dead space is a place that separates the panel presses, which is advantageous for base form players because they will hit the wrong panel less often. If you compare that to how like an SMX pad looks, which is completely square, that gap is not there. So when you're moving your foot in between like up and right or up and left, you have to make sure that you're lifting your foot off so that you don't trigger or keep your foot held on up too long. Does that make sense? You know, it's not a deal killer having perfectly square panels, but there are some people who don't prefer square panels, and that's why. So who plays with base form? Well, a lot of people do. And if you've ever seen the stamina ladder, I mean, pretty much all of the top folks are. Jim says, it's pretty versatile and can be used for foot speed or FA, but you can injure the tendon on the top of your foot where the foot connects to the leg. There was a time when I was trying to learn base form, and I was just kind of like sneaking it into a song here or there, and I completely like ruined that tendon that he's talking about, and I had problems with like dorsiflexion afterwards. It was very, very painful, and it lasted a long time. Dingoshi left a response on this form that could make a video on its own. It's very long and very detailed and very good. I'm just going to throw it up on the screen and people can pause it and read it if they want. Sir Dellen says, I think it is generally more energy efficient since I can tap with your toes rather than your whole heel, but I feel it also requires more precise and sensitive modding, especially if you slide more. PK Gam says that this form is very bar friendly because while you're leaning back, your toes have less weight on them, and thus you can kind of pivot off your heels a little bit easier. He also said, it does seem to be an iffy style to use for crossovers. Not sure what those are. So NATO says, here's my mechanical engineer tinfoil hat theory. Preach, NATO, let's hear it. When I play toes out, I pivot my foot about my heel to hit left and right and back again to hit up. Since I play no bar, almost all my body weight is on my heels, increasing the force due to friction and thus the amount of torque my legs need to exert to complete the pivot. I suspect this is how I got injured. So those are really like the three distinct forms that I can think of. But there is another combination that is probably more prevalent, which is just like mixed asymmetrical or disbalanced form. This is really like when you combine like two of the forms listed above. A good example of this is like Sidro. So he has one foot that's kind of like straight and then one foot that's like much more like toes out. Now, there is a special kind of variant of this asymmetrical form that is angled or slanted. So if you are one of these people who plays toes out on one foot and heels out on the other foot, you can find that some people eventually will turn their whole body just a little bit, and I call that angled form. The two primary examples that I know of are 2% Milk and Nico. When you look at these players, they're just kind of like off to the side. Every other player is just like facing forward. Amy and Ian are just kind of like, you know, 45 degrees this way. Nitties does this a little bit as well. Nitties says it's good. Some people have had hip injuries with hybrid forms, but it's solid. For efficiency's sake, base form seems to be the best, with straight coming in second and heels out last, but it highly depends on your modding and setup. Of course, it's hard to compare because most people only have a single form. So there are some, you know, real powerhouses that have this, you know, mixed up asymmetrical form. All right, so those are the types of forms. Which form should you use, and is based best? I think based might be best. Most of the top players are based, and anecdotally, people who seem to rise through the ranks on the stamina ladder the fastest, they tend to be based. A good example of this is like, you know, Rust. But, you know, reality check, if you look at the stamina ladder, there's somebody with each style of form from 24 onward. So does it even matter? Realistically, you and I aren't going to be passing any 24s anytime soon. So any minor competitive edge that you might get from one form or another, it's probably moot. Besides, for many people, it's not really like a choice. It's just what your body is comfortable with, or what works for your pad modding, or the shape of your panels, or all those other variables. We have seen some people trying to change their form, and I think some people, there's plenty of people who have done it. Arkai has done it, and he said that he did so by like slowly working up and, you know, playing a few songs each set. But he still, you know, sticks with heels out for his hardest stuff, I believe. So my advice is to do what's comfortable with you. I really wanted a different form than what I landed on, but at the end of the day, I'm trying to play. I'm trying to not get injured so I can play more. The best way to do that is just to listen to your body and just do what comes natural. The number one priority for anyone who's playing stamina is avoiding injury. I really believe that's true. Getting injured with like your legs or your back or your wrists or your shoulders, there's so many things to get injured by, and they will just take you out of the game for a long time. And yeah, going a couple of weeks without playing, it can really set you back. Just keep in mind, I mean, we all need to push ourselves when we play stamina and foot speed, but if you're pushing through like joint pain, that has to be avoided. But all that said, if I had the choice of just snapping my fingers and just changing my form to whatever I wanted, I'd probably prefer to have base form. And, you know, I'd really want to avoid angled or asymmetric form. It's obviously, it works for a ton of people, and they're, you know, they're fine with it. You don't want one leg to have stronger muscles than the other in different places. So, yeah, it doesn't seem advantageous to me. But anyways, as Carl would say, this don't matter, ain't none of this matters. So yeah, that's my take on stamina form. Maybe the next time you're watching a stamina streamer, you'll have a better idea of what they're doing. And see you next time.